Did Florida lawmakers and the governor just make it harder for college students to vote in 2020?
The League of Women Voters says yes, and they filed a lawsuit against the state. NBC2 chief political correspondent Dave Elias poured over the suit today, and he's live on the campus of FSW to explain what it's all about.
Yeah, election law new this year that was just signed by the governor is requiring a significant amount of parking in front of each polling place. Now, that does not include parking lots with permit parking, which is often found on college campuses like this one here at FSW. Now, this was stuck into the bill at the very last minute. In fact, one Florida lawmaker is telling me tonight she didn't even know they stuck it in there.
For students in college, it's harder to just go out and go to places to just vote, and it'll be so much easier if they have a place open here.
College students have long argued for polling places on campuses in Florida.
If we just see a poll, we can go and vote very easily.
Florida's League of Women Voters argue it just got harder.
We have a pattern in our legislature of trying to suppress certain segments of the population from easy voting.
A new law says that early voting sites must provide sufficient non-permitted parking to accommodate voters.
It is very difficult to see a neutral reason for that requirement.
Attorney Peter Dennis says it strikes at the heart of college campuses.
The fact that it was placed in the amendment at the very last minute, there wasn't a lot of discussion on it.
Some lawmakers admit they didn't even know that it was added.
I'm going to be holding myself to a higher standard as well and ensuring that we try to catch these things when they happen.
Republican Dane Eagle arguing the right to vote should not be predetermined on whether a voter has purchased a parking permit. A student's response?
The parking here is free, and there's a lot of parking lots here.
Now, you'll recall that Governor Rick Scott's administration said colleges weren't sufficient as early voting sites. Well, a judge ruled that unconstitutional. 11 campuses opened up early voting sites in 2018, attracting some 60,000 voters. Now, I did talk with Lee County's election supervisor, and he tells me that there are no plans to have early voting sites on Lee County school campuses. We're live in Fort Myers. Dave Elias, NBC2.